Hello all, welcome to Money Techs Guru. In this video, I have planned to show you the work which is my all-time favorite. Yes, it's a garment dyeing. The kids' garment which I have shown in the image is with the multicolor spiral effect, dyed using cold brand reactive dyes. The technique which I have used here is injection garment dyeing. I hope this injection garment dyeing technique is new to you. I'll explain you what it is. In this technique, the dye transfer will happen using a medical syringe. So I have named it as injection garment dyeing. Process route. The injection garment dyeing with cold brand reactive dyes is a 4-step process. Number 1, RFD garment pre-treatment and cold brand reactive dyes dissolution. Number 2, tie the pre-treated garment based on the after dyeing result we require. Number 3, injection garment dyeing using medical syringe followed by fixation. Number 4, post treatment or washing treatment to improve the fastness properties of the garment. Come on buddies, let's see practically how this multicolor spiral effect is done using injection garment dyeing technique. Step 1, RFD garment pre-treatment and cold brand reactive dye dissolution. Before pre-treatment, I have made the pre-treatment recipe ready. The pre-treatment recipe consists of weight of the garment 80 grams. The MLR, material to liquid ratio, I have planned to use here is 1:2. So volume of water required will be 80 × 2, 160 ml. Soda ash or sodium carbonate to give the alkaline pH 20 GPL. Salt or NaCl required to reduce the zeta potential between the garment and cold brand reactive dyes is 40 GPL. With this recipe details, we can easily calculate the amount of soda ash and salt requirement. The actual soda ash or sodium carbonate requirement is 20 GPL. That is, 20 gram of soda ash need to be added for 1000 ml of water. Since here we have 160 ml of water, so 3.2 gram of soda ash is dissolved in 160 ml of water. In the same way, the actual requirement of salt or sodium chloride is 40 GPL. That is, 40 gram of soda ash need to be added for 1000 ml of water. Since we have volume of water is 160 ml, so 6.4 gram of salt is dissolved in 160 ml of water. Now, the RFD garment is immersed in the salt and soda ash dissolved liquor and soaked it for 2 hours and then finally skewed and dried. The reason behind this pre-treatment process is to increase the attraction between dye molecule and fiber and covalent bond formation between the dye and the cotton fiber. Salt does the job of increasing the attraction between dye molecule and the fiber, and the soda ash does the job of covalent bond formation between the dye molecule and fiber, because covalent bond formation will happen in the alkaline pH. For this dyeing trial, I have chosen 4 colors: yellow, orange, blue and red. I have made 1% standard solution in all the 4 colors and stored it in a PET jar. I have sourced these colors from Gujarat Dyes and Chemicals, Tirupur. They have many other colors too. I have provided their contact detail in the description. Whoever wants to procure, you can use the contact details. The powder dye stuff is weighed accurately and pasted with liquid soap to improve the dissolution, and added distilled water based on the depth percentage required and filtered using cloth filter. Since the dye transfer happens using medical syringe, there should not be any lumps for trouble-free dyeing. Step 2, tie the RFD pre-treated garment based on the after dyeing result we require. The pre-treated dried garment is reversed before the tying process is started. The reversed garment is placed on a flat surface. To create the spiral effect, I have used the fork. The fork is placed exactly at the center of the garment and rotated to create the spiral effect in the garment. The pleats which is getting created during rotation are arranged in a proper manner to get the uniform effect. Much patience is required while creating the pleats for this spiral effect. Finally, the created pleats are tied using the rubber bands. Do not use too much of rubber bands. One or two rubber bands is sufficient to tie the pleats. I have divided equally 8 equal offs using 4 set of rubber bands. The excess pleats are adjusted inside the tied rubber bands. Now the RFD garment is ready for dyeing. Step 3, injection garment dyeing using medical syringe. I have planned to do injection garment dyeing at an MLR, material to liquor ratio, of 1:1. That is, 80 gram garment will be dyed using 80 ml of dye liquor. Since I have planned to apply 4 colors, I have taken 20 ml of each shade from the 1% standard solution. Here I am transferring the dye stuff using medical syringe. I have planned to apply 2 colors on one side and 2 colors on another side. On one side, I am applying blue and yellow. Since there is 8 equal halves, on odd halves, I am applying blue color. Totally, there are 4 equal odd halves, 5 ml per one half. So the complete 20 ml of dye liquor will be transferred. Now the first half is completed. Accordingly, third half is dyed using blue color, followed by fifth and finally the seventh half is getting applied with blue color. In the same way, the second color is applied using medical syringe on the even halves of the first side. Since we have filtered the dye liquor using cloth filter, there is no hindrance or blocking of lumps during the dye application. Just like blue color, yellow colors are also applied at 5 ml per one half. So the complete 20 ml is transferred. Now the first even half application of the yellow color is completed. Accordingly, fourth, sixth and eighth half are getting applied with yellow color. Now the first side of injection garment dyeing is completed. It can be reversed now for dyeing the second side. Actually, to place the garment for injection garment dyeing, I have used a household wire mesh which we are using in our day-to-day activities. Now the second side is ready for dyeing using another set of two colors. Just like blue color on the first side, red color is applied on the odd halves of the second side. Complete 20 ml of red color dye liquor is transferred to all four odd halves of the second side. Now the first odd half is completed, followed by third odd half is getting dyed using medical syringe. Accordingly, fifth odd half and seventh odd half is applied with red color using medical syringe. Finally, the even halves of the second side is dyed with orange color using medical syringe. Even here, the complete 20 ml of dye liquor is distributed evenly across all the four even halves of the second side. After completing the first even half, the fourth, sixth, and eighth half are applied with orange color using the medical syringe. Now the injection garment dyeing is completed. For dye fixation, it needs to be kept undisturbed for 24 hours, followed by step 4 washing treatment. After dye fixation, the rubber bands are removed and the garment is taken for washing treatment to remove the unfixed dyes and to improve the fastness properties of the garment. The washing treatment consists of cold wash followed by neutralization using 0.25% acetic acid. This acetic acid is available in Amazon, followed by cold soaping, cold wash, and finally dried. Final outlook of the garment. I have enclosed the final outlook of the injection garment dyed with multicolor spiral effect. The image on the left is the face side of the garment and image on the right is the back side of the garment. Since we have followed all the dyeing procedures properly, the garment has exhibited good color fastness properties and found there is no concentrated dye liquor effluent released from the garment after dyeing. This is because the garment dyeing is executed in dry state, so the complete dye liquor is absorbed by the garment. Hope this video is useful and informative. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, like and share. Please post your comments in the comments box. Catch you all in the next video. Till then, bye from Money Tech Guru. Bye bye.